haiku, not endless verses of nothingness. I eat organic red rice, not that adulterated polished bullshit you had for dinner last night. I was actually happy when Robb Stark died because it saved him the humiliation of being a terrible shame. I have manic depression, not the regular one. Except my Coldplay over Ghost Stories, Coldplay any day. And lastly, John Green sucks. And I wish people could be hipsters are a subculture of men and women and all those in between who value independent thought, creativity, counterculturalism, and most importantly, exclusivity. I log on to Facebook and share a few pictures from Berlin Art Parasites, although I barely understand the poetry, let alone the abstract art that accompanies it. I also strongly worded that about the ethics of censorship in the media or the declining role of secularism in our pseudo-democracy or honestly about any other topic that people are writing about at the time so that I don't miss the opportunity to jump onto the bandwagon and let everybody have my perspective on the issue known, which is absolutely brilliant. I caught myself rocking out to Shake It Off in the shower the other day and quickly began to hum Few Releases instead. As a hipster, I'm a part of the subculture of men and women and all those in between who value independent thought, creativity, counterculturalism, and most importantly, exclusivity. I write an open letter to that manslut John Mayer for objectifying women in his ridiculous pop song, Your Body is a Wonderland. At night, I dream of your candy lips and your bubblegum tongue. I Instagrammed a picture of a rusted lamp I found at Chol Bazaar, picked a filter that made it look older and more mystical than it really was, and captioned it with a little triangle, I mean delta. And when someone asked me what it meant, I gleefully yet incredibly pretentiously responded with, it's a symbol of a band I've been following them since their first release. And today, after almost a year, I will show everyone the same picture and caption as proof that I listened to Alt-G way before any of these. And to hide that I was too broke to go, I'll justify my absence at their concert in my city by saying that after becoming popular, they lost their musical touch. And as a result, at the show, I'd be in the company of regular people, not anyone belonging to the same subculture of men and women and all those in between who value independent thought, creativity, counterculturalism, and most importantly, exclusivity. Everyone treated me differently when I was in school because I was different and I loved it. The air of pompousness that I was allowed to have was accepted as being my defining characteristic. When they called me a hipster, I knew I'd arrived and made my mark as someone who's independent, creative, culturally abrasive, and very, very exclusive. I spiced this up with my own little rebellion, and somewhere along the line, I began to repress my secret liking for what was actually in style. I go to a liberal arts school in Pune now. So most of us are social rejects from our previous schools and colleges. All of us are hipsters in our own right. Here, I'm considered different for choosing to study math and stats over gender studies. I couldn't take the pressure anymore, and in a bid to get noticed, I had to come out of the closet as a direction. It worked. Basically, whatever made me hipster earlier now made me the same as everyone else. And I realized that in this newly discovered sea of men and women and all those in between who value independent thought, creativity, counterculturalism, and most importantly, exclusivity, mainstream is the new hipster. The sociology of what it truly is to be a hipster is far too complicated for me. I can't fathom for the life of me the number of permutations and combinations, likes, dislikes, characteristics, and emotions that make up a single human being, let alone 7.2 billion of them. I openly reject conformism, yet I strive to be dissimilar, which is a very prominent type in itself. I'm aware of the truth that the unalike are alike. Still, every night, just before I sleep, I visit my blog, www.complicatedadjective followed by a lesser known noun.tumblr.com. So natural, so unique, in the hope that my followers will appreciate me for not believing in the societal norms of attractiveness. I'm celebrating the human body's untouched form and accepting it for its inherent beauty. This, after sticking my chubby finger down my throat, so I can mold myself, fit into the plaid shirt and the tight jeans that make me a student.